Recently, I felt in my heart, the best thing to do is to drop my comedy special to my fans for free. So now what needs to happen is I have to write some more content. I'm gonna show you how I write jokes. Really, I'm just showing my work. You're probably not gonna laugh out loud watching this video. This is the process. Yo, welcome back. Welcome back. We don't even have a name for this yet. This is the Michael Jr. joke writing process that I'm sharing with you so you can actually see how the jokes are made. We've already done the first five steps. I won't go through them. I'll just say what they are real fast. We walked through the premise. We did a, we called an associated person. I called a comedian friend. I talked it through, and now boom, we're gonna call a random person. Why are we gonna call a random person in the middle of this process? The reason is because we have some content. We got some stuff that's kind of good, but it was kind of in blob form. So now what I'm gonna do, because I don't wanna just wait until I get on stage to find out if this stuff is gonna hit hard or not. Instinctively, I kind of know what's gonna be funny and what's not, but I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure. But now I gotta kind of massage it. So I could wait until I get on the stage and present it to the people. But there's a step that I can do before I even get on stage, which is this step. Call a random person and try to slip some of this content into the conversation and see how they respond. The key here is to make it sound conversational, because if it sounds kind of like I'm doing a set on them, it'll be a little weird, a little awkward, and I just don't want that to happen. And then you won't get an authentic response. I need to be able to slip this into a conversation in a way where they laugh, where they say that's funny, and it gives me a feel for it without them knowing that I'm really just using this opportunity to see if my jokes are working. So the person I'm gonna call right now is this guy named Jason Earls, awesome friend, and he does comedy, but we're really gonna focus on our friendship right now. Second time I called him, see if he answers.
Please leave your message for 2142.
I should have left his number on there so y'all can call him too and be like, why don't you answer the phone when Michael Jr. called you? Clearly not a friend, I'm just playing, he's awesome. All right, and then what did I say for the third person? I had somebody else. Call Hector. I haven't talked to Hector in a while.
Hey, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
I'm good, man. Just picking up somewhat lunch for the family.
Lunch, really? What are you eating? What are you guys gonna eat?
Nah, I just came to grab a sandwich or two from Whataburger.
Oh, Whataburger. So you're eating some meat, huh? Wow. I thought you guys were you ever thinking, didn't we have a conversation where you were thinking about being a vegetarian?
I don't know, man. I think we had a conversation about doing a low-carb diet.
Oh. Yeah, because I'm vegan free. I don't mess around with just the. Okay, thanks, man. Thanks. So how you guys doing, man?
Good, man. I'm recovering from COVID. Alicia's still recovering from the flu and COVID.
Oh, she had them both, huh? Wow. It's crazy. Sorry to hear that, man. Maybe if you guys...
I didn't know that was even possible.
Yeah, she's an overachiever. I wonder if it would have been as serious if she was only eating vegetables.
I don't know.
Huh. Because I'm thinking about being a vegetarian. That's why I'm asking these questions. I'm considering it. But I'm probably gonna be like a second generation vegetarian. Like, I'm only gonna eat animals who were vegetarians. That's probably how I'm gonna do it.
That's probably how you do it, that's true. Let's give it a try, bro, come on.
Challenge
it, let's do it.
Yeah, absolutely. Here's what's, hey, you ever had that Impossible Burger before?
Nah.
Have you heard about it? It's like a burger that doesn't have any meat in it. It's like an Impossible Burger. That's what they call it. It's no meat. It's no meat, and it's supposed to taste like a hamburger. I think it used to be called a Big Mac, though. I'm not sure.
That's some processed food, then. I don't know. I don't even think I'll trust anything like that.
Yeah, but you're at Whataburger right now, though.
Yeah.
So that's probably... Anyway, do you have any friends that are vegetarians?
I have one friend. I can't remember who it was.
Oh.
I have one friend that went vegetarian.
Were they? What's
his name?
Were they trying to be evangelistic with their vegetarianism?
Not really. They just had a bad experience with something and decided to change their ways.
Oh, they got hurt. They got hurt. Yeah. Okay. Cool, man. Hey, so I'm thinking about starting this business. Can I tell you what it is real quick?
Yeah, what's up?
So you know how vegetarians will take vegetables and turn them into meat? I mean, turn it into, like, they'll create bacon made out of vegetables?
Yeah.
So I was thinking of doing the opposite, where I could offer, like a salad that's made out of pork.
Right. A salad made out of pork?
So, for example, like tofu. You never had tofu before because you eat meat. But you know how people say tofu can taste just like meat? Well, what if I made some meat, like some chitlins, that tastes like tofu?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. That would be amazing, wouldn't it?
That would be interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You try it out, I'll be your guinea pig.
You gonna test? Oh, that's right, because you're Puerto Rican. Y'all just, as long as it's pork, you're going to eat it.
That's right. Come on.
That is dope. All right, you're awesome, dude. I love you, man. All
right, man. Love you too, brother. Take care. Thanks for calling me. Checking out.
Hey,
man. It's been a minute.
Hey, notice how I just said, hey, I love you. And I just left it at that. And you had to put the word brother on the back end of it. Like, why come you couldn't just stop at I love you? Because it's a little more awkward when you do that. Have you noticed that?
It could be a little awkward, but you know what I'm saying? I talk a lot. So.
Well, give it a shot. Just try it. Just
beat me, Michael.
Just stop at I love you. Just try it. Just stop at I love you.
I got you. I love you, man. Later.
You said man. You could not say man. You see that? You had to put man on the end of it.
my bad. It's a habit.
Uh-huh. All right.
Later.
Say it.
I don't know.
It's way different. It is different, right?
It's a habit, man.
Yeah, but you know it's a habit. You're aware of it now, so give it a shot.
All right, man. Love you. So I just hang up?
Why? You got to say something so quick after I love you. Anyway, all right, you dope, man. I appreciate you, bro. All
right, man. Talk to you later.
All right, cool. Yo, so listen. With the jokes, that was a complete bust. However, the goal is I came up with another premise. It is harder to just simply say I love you, because people always want to put something on the back end of it, because that softens the you part and I love. Some people always trying to put a softener back there, so I could create some comedy about that. And then what'll happen is, anyway, let's stay focused. So, although it may not have seemed like it was an amazing phone call as far as external laughter, there is something that he said that was kind of cool in there that could actually lead to more comedy. And here's what it is. When he said he had one friend who was a vegetarian and they did it because they got hurt, that is money right there. Like, there's something there. Because now I could say, hey, I was talking to a vegetarian friend and I was like, what happened? He's like, man, I got sick, man. I was eating meat. Like, I'm like, what happened in this? Like, did you give the meat a second chance, or you just close the door? Like, there's no possibility of reconciliation. Sometimes you need to talk these things through. Don't be too hostile about the situation. I mean, there could still be something there, right? You just gonna overcorrect. Like, you got hurt. Okay, red meat hurt you, but do you have to jump all the way to celery right now? Like, there's got to be an in between. It's just not healthy to be bouncing back and forth like that. I'm saying there's a little something there. I'm just throwing it out there, like on the real. So now, in the last and final step, how do I take all of this and connect it to life? Because remember, comedy is just a tool that I use to open up hearts and get people enjoying. Like, people will show up to my comedy shows because they want to laugh, but that's not always what they need. So the next step will be, how do I connect this to life? You'll see that in the next video. I appreciate you guys so much. Thanks for being a part of this. Go watch the comedy special in the meanwhile, and then you'll see this next step, next and final step after this.